will be dead for good.
What have you done? You've killed him!
This guy was an arm, but that was pathetic.
I can feel a faint pulse. I think he's going to be all right.
Well, of course I'm going to be all right. He only grazed my arm. Has he gone?
Yeah, he stalked off.
Good. Then I think we should make a hasty exit. I don't know. Ah! I think he's in. Must have been better than I thought.
Oh, it's going to need some treatment, is this, Doctor?
I know very well what it needs. What we need is an advantage. And time. And we don't have either without the TARDIS.
Well, what do you suppose the Master's trying to do, exactly?
Isn't he going to use the Dalek armor to invade? I mean, that's what Davros was going to do.
Well, that was his original plan. But the Master has many intentions and goals. One of which is to go to Gallifrey with that wretched time crystal. And how the Daleks fit into it, I don't know.
What is this time crystal, anyway? Why is it so important?
Well, it's not even a time crystal as such. It doesn't store time or anything. It just has properties from the way it was formed.
Didn't you once tell me it was part of a meteorite?
Yes. A meteorite from the Crab Nebula. Caused by a supernova explosion.
Body is still there when we get back from the cryo freeze. Now, help me with this.
So, the crystal affects time slightly. But from what you say, your people on Gallifrey can do that already, so what's the problem?
The problem is that when the crystal is put in front of a laser source, the glow creates a beam of high-intensity radiation which can affect any Time Lord. Because of its structure, when that glow is back into a beam, it can destroy my cells and stop my powers of regeneration. I'll never be able to regenerate again.
And the Master's got to get rid of the Doctor before he can get the crystal and take it to Gallifrey and take the whole civilization hostage.
Right.
That's his plan.
But the Master could do all those things without any help from anybody.
True, but he must need the Daleks for something, otherwise he would have hot-footed it out of there and gone.
So, now what?
Now we've put the Dalek ship out of operation. And I've got an idea how to do just that.
There we are. That'll do the job perfectly.
Out.
two of the Dalek creatures are guarding the suspension system.
Then the army has already been revived, or else the Daleks have got here before us and are reviving the army now.
We can leave this planet, since the Dalek army now has assistance.
No, we should attempt to gain control. A 1,000 strong army at our control will be a valuable asset, and would give us ultimate control of the Dalek race. This opportunity holds too much potential to discard it based on conjecture. We will locate the Dalek craft and attempt to negotiate in order to gain control.
Right, I found what you need. Some loon in America sent a load of data about defense scrambling and missile signals onto the net. Ah, should be everything you need there. Excellent. Now, I'm ready to take the two TARDISes to the cryo-freeze and set up the transmat grid. By cross-connecting them, I will be able to teleport the whole army at once.
Then the Earth will be incapable of functioning and its defences will be useless.
Exactly. Once any entity has no defence systems, there is very little it can do against the nuclear attacks. We must go to the cryo-freeze now and set up this transmat system.
You never know when these things are going to come in handy.
And weed killer.
To make a bomb. Well, I hope you're going to find somewhere inconspicuous to make this bomb.
So, how much of this stuff are you going to use?
As much as possible.
Well, what exactly are you planning to do with this bomb? It's hardly big enough to damage the ship.
No, but it'll be big enough to blast the generators on the ship. And anything to slow down the master will give us an advantage. And with the master inconvenienced, we can nip back to the cryo-freeze and destroy the Dalek army once and for all. And hopefully get the TARDIS back. Otherwise I'll never be able to, well...
Able to what?
Stop the master. There. That should just about do it. Now all we have to do is get this little magic box onto the ship.
Well, I hope the guy in black isn't waiting for you. It might be a better shot next time.
Oh, I doubt it. The master probably thinks I'm dead by now. Besides which, I'm sure he's got other uses for him.
Yeah, well, he didn't expect a welcoming committee last time, but there was.
True. I suppose if we wait until it gets a bit darker. Shouldn't be much longer, then I can slip on unseen.
Cables, and I will rematerialize the Doctor's TARDIS next to mine. It's strange, but I never thought the Doctor would be of any use to me, really. I wish he were here to witness it in a way. The irony would probably kill me, if you hadn't killed me already.
No trouble, I trust.
No trouble, Master.
Good. Now, I am ready to transport your army to the power station and cripple this pathetic planet once and for all. Now, the invasion can begin.
The Daleks will invade the Earth. We will go on and conquer.
Yes, Very soon, Gallifrey will be mine, and no intervention from the Doctor. Quickly, Saval. We must complete the cross-coupling and transmute the Daleks. Everything is set. Excellent.
What's in here?
Oh, well, it's dark enough now. I'm off into the ship.
No, Flung. Both of you will have to wait here. I'm sorry, but it would be far easier for one person to get around the ship without being seen. If anything were to happen, it wouldn't do for all of us to be caught.
Well, how do you know you won't get caught in the blast? I mean, you don't know how strong that bomb is.
Don't worry. I'll set the timer for a fair amount of time. But give me a chance to get clear. And look, I've got to go into the ship. Don't wait till...
Doctor!
What?
Good luck.
I hope you succeed.
Thank you.
Excellent. Once the transmat grid is complete, the Daleks go out and play.
Authorized presence in Sector B.
I will investigate.
He's been caught. What shall we do?
Well, he needed the TARDIS. And we might be able to help him if he's in trouble.
Flynn, he said wait.
Well, we have waited for half an hour. We've got to do something. Come on.
There. The transport group is set. Each of those individual groups of Daleks will be simultaneously transported to a different power station across the globe. I need you to operate the controls in my TARDIS. You know what you are doing?
I think so. You count down from five. Then I switch the controls. As you should, when you get to zero.
Exactly. And the Daleks will appear all over the globe and take over the electricity network. This planet will be helpless. And then the main part of my plan will begin.
Yeah.
The Master isn't planning a collaboration with them.
Then he did what?
Turned and took the gun out of my hand. It was those pesky kids, they distracted me. He took it in a split second my back was turned.
Well, why didn't you attack him? He's supposed to be an assassin, remember?
He had the gun trained on me. What do you expect me to do?
A gun is useless on human tissue. It destroys regenerative powers.
The Daleks are not alone. We form the tunnel.
You might have destroyed your unit. This is someone else.
The one who calls himself the Master.
Exterminate the invaders! Destroy them!
What? Don't you dare act without my instructions! Why are you here?
We came to seek allegiance with the Daleks, but it appears you have set up a collaboration of your own.
Yes, I'm afraid so. You will wait here whilst I decide what to do about these beings. I am prepared to offer you a compromise.
The Dalek army at this minute is spread throughout the planet and has totally destroyed the electricity network. The planet is crippled, but won't be for long, so I must seize the moment whilst it lasts. As you can see, this ship has been sabotaged and is useless as a result.
The Daleks are not prepared to work with us. We also have reservations regarding your loyalties. You betrayed us in the death zone on Gallifrey.
Listen, this ship is useless, but I have in my possession a weapon that will enable me to take over all Gallifrey and use the Time Lord technology to colonize control more than half the cosmos. All I require is your ship to help me complete the plan.
We do not trust you. If you intend to conquer Gallifrey, one of you need to disable the Earth. You can invade Gallifrey with your weapons, and the Daleks need play no part in your plan. Why do you need the Earth?
The gun I have developed needs a copious amount of energy and a craft to mount it in. The power for the gun could only be obtained from a controlled fusion reaction. I have developed such a facility, and with the Daleks holding the planet in deadlock, I can metamorphose all the seawater on this scumball of a world, and use a large concentration of heavy water to power my gun.
The Daleks are only a superficial part of your plan, then.
I only need them until I have the fuel for the fusion reactor. Then we can go to Gallifrey with the gun in your craft, and the Daleks can be left behind. It's what they always wanted anyway, control of the Earth, though I have no idea why.
Not without validity. How do we know you will not desert us once Gallifrey is under your control?
How can I? You will be there also, and there are more of you than there are of me. How could I possibly present a threat to your might and power? All I ask is that you supply me with enough energy pods to power the ship for long enough to get the fuel. Then we will be ready.
We agree. Once the fuel is on this ship, the Daleks here can be destroyed. Then we can begin.
Excellent. I knew we could come to a mutual agreement. Wait here.
You have negotiated with the Cybermen. What is the result?
Listen. The Cybermen have a ship not very far from here and have agreed to provide us with enough energy pods to restore power to your craft. The plan can go on unaltered.
We have never collaborated with the Cybermen in the past. I do not trust their loyalty.
You have never needed the Cybermen in the past, but it would be stupid to abandon this master plan when the Cybermen have the resources we need and are willing to offer.
What do they expect in return?
I have told them that they can have leadership of certain areas of the cosmos, but in reality, I have no intention of keeping that promise. I will not betray your loyalty, do not fear.
The Cybermen will still be a threat. They will have to travel to Gallifrey as well.
No, they won't. Once your army is returned, it will be a simple task to destroy these two Cybermen. Then we will have what we need. The Cybermen need no longer be an issue, and the plan can continue as intended.
We agree. The Cybermen can provide a solution to this temporary setback. Then be exterminated.
Exactly. Anything surplus to requirements must be destroyed.
The longer we wait, the less I like it.
Well, what exactly are we waiting for?
Well, the Cybermen have just entered the Dalek ship. I would have expected some sort of resistance, a skirmish of some sort. It's unnerving. There's been nothing at all.
The Cybermen may be negotiating with the Master.
Precisely, and that's a bad sign for all concerned. If Davros is dead, and the Cybermen form an alliance with the Daleks, led by the Master, the prospect is horrific. I mean, with the Master's cunning and intellect, the Cybermen's strength and stamina, and the Daleks' psychopathic hatred. But I've got to get the TARDIS back, there's no doubt about it. I've got to get on board that ship.
With such an alliance, to go now would be suicide.
You'd only succeed in getting yourself caught again. Then the Master would be sure to kill you. Given that Hitman of his has tried so far and failed, I'm sure the Master would take care of it personally.
You're right, of course. I'll just have to wait for the right moment when they're occupied.
What do you mean by that?
Well, the bomb must have caused some damage, or the ship would have gone. The Master must have struck up some sort of deal with the Cybermen. So he'll either commandeer their ship or use the energy units to power the Dalek ship.
Couldn't he just repair the damage?
Not very easily. I mean, you felt the blast.
Yeah.
And he wouldn't need to bargain with the Cybermen if he was simply going to repair it. No. It's evident that the Cybermen have some considerable use. So the Master and the Cybermen will have to leave to get to the Cybership. Once they're gone, it's going to be our only chance. Because with the Cybermen involved, we'll never get the TARDIS back once they return. We'll have to go in as soon as they leave. The question is, when?
Excellent. We have agreed on a satisfactory alliance. Now, we need to collect the energy pods from your craft and bring them here, to the Dalek ship. We will go in my TARDIS, and I can return the Dalek army to the warehouse, ready for the next step. Whilst we are away, you can begin to disconnect the damaged power units ready for our return.
That is agreed.
Sebal comes with us. I need him to operate the Doctor's TARDIS whilst I retrieve the Dalek army. At least that's one thing he seems adequate at doing.
TARDIS. Yes, the Master's TARDIS. There's a good chance that mine will still be on the ship.
Well, are you taking us with him?
No, I doubt it. It'll only be extra weight. And the one thing the Master doesn't have right now is spare energy.
Come on. This is our only chance. There's only two Daleks on the ship. Surely we can overcome them to get to the TARDIS.
Why do you need to retrieve the Dalek army? Surely they have no use now. Your betrayal is always a factor you must consider.
No, no. I am retrieving the Dalek army for one very good reason. When they are retrieved, they will arrive at what location?
The cryo freeze.
Exactly. And then they can be frozen to death by bringing the temperature down to absolute zero. 273 degrees below freezing.
Then the Dalek army will no longer be a threat. Excellent.
Now, you must wait here until I have given the word. The plan is going very well. Everything is going as expected. Except this. Splendid. Now, you must take their place and keep a lookout here whilst I finish off this little task. Maneuvering the Dalek army has put a considerable strain on the two energy generators. We may have to go to the Cybership on foot and leave the TARDIS to recover for a while. Come on, we have little time to spare. I must get in and lower the temperature.
Thank you. success now, Doctor, and I am not letting you get in my way.
Complete your plan, if you're so invincible.
No! Don't harm!
Go on, Doctor. Pull the trigger.
Now the final part of my plan can commence.